There's two basic mineral oils. Well, there's three, but the third one's pretty rare. Group one and group two. Group one is very low refined, and group two is more highly refined. And as a result, the group two has a lot better characteristics than the group one. Group one has a very low flash point, and so on the hot upper cylinder, it will evaporate off very quickly, leaving the cylinder unprotected, which is why no manufacturer makes an engine oil that's 100% group one mineral oil. So here's the differences between synthetics and group two. Synthetics leave a high amount of spooge, which is the result of their high heat resistance. And group two leaves a low amount of spooge. This is what I'm talking about. Do you like cleaning this off every time? I certainly don't. The protection of synthetics is high, and group two is medium high. How you would distinguish whether or not you need a synthetic or not is by the spark plug heat range. If you're using a number 9 or higher NGK, that's a high heat engine. And you're best off with an engine oil that is at least 1/2 synthetic. If you're using a number 8 like I am, group 2 mineral oil is just fine. Excellent protection. The amount you add to gas is very low with a synthetic because it's like a concentrated product, basically. And it's a moderate amount with group two. The deposits are low with synthetics, so if you're just, you know, really disinclined to do engine maintenance, and especially if you have a power valve, maybe you should go with synthetics and just deal with the spooge. But I like working on machines. To turn on put on some 70s rock and roll and spend an afternoon in the garage is heaven to me. What I want to show you here now is one product that is half synthetic, half group two. And it is the only one on the market like that. Okay, all the others throw some group one in there, which brings the protection down, it brings the carbon deposits up, it brings the smoke up. It's just a cheap substitute for what they should be adding to it. Kawasaki did it right. Unfortunately, you can't buy this online. You have to go to a Kawasaki shop to buy it. Highly, highly advised. These three right here are group two mineral oils. They don't have any group one added to them. And the rating is for the Syn Plus is FD, which is lower smoke, higher detergents, and less dry mineral lubricant. So this is made for use on the street, okay, if you're not drag racing, that is. These two, the FB rating is better for dirt bikes or racing bikes. And their ratings, their specifications are comparable to the TC rating. This right here shows how the upper cylinder temperature is hotter than the lower. Of course, you'd expect that because the higher parts of it are exposed to the heat more than the lower areas of it. Another advantage of using a pure group 2 or a synthetic and group 2 mix is that it matches the most common type of CDI used, which is the type that does not adjust for high load situations. This RM250 CDI does. This is normal running, and then under high load, it retards ignition. And for my test, you know, please refer to my other videos, the synthetic and the group 2 oils are better matched to CDIs that have a set timing curve. They do not adjust with the load. And that's the way most CDIs are. So that's it, short and sweet. I guess I should mention about the flash point. The flash point is the temperature at which an oil will flash off of a metal part due to the heat. It'll evaporate, okay? So in the hot upper cylinder, which is usually gets up to like between somewhere between 150 and 200 degrees Celsius, the synthetic's not gonna flash off at all. Nor the group 2. They both give good protection on the hot upper cylinder. But like I said, you can get above that 200 degrees with some racing engines, in which case you want at least a semi-synthetic for a true racing engine. Just look at the spark plug's heat range number. And the flash point of group 1 mineral oil is like 38 to 99 degrees. I don't know why anyone uses group 1 mineral oil anymore. So there you have it. This is something I recently found out about. Someone told me about it. Highly recommended. If you get a water-cooled bike and you're using number 8 or number 7 plug, either of these three is good. For the street, I'd recommend this. And for the dirt, I'd recommend either of these two. Unless you like spooge. Thanks for watching.